Greetings, Kiss Nation. Dave, this is going to be another long review where we're going to be talking about what Kiss has done currently in the studio. And the first item today is this, the 2008 Japanese album of re-recorded Kiss songs. And for a while, this was the only way you can get this album as the Japanese import. And when I heard about this album, I thought, cool, this is really cool. And the re-recorded versions of these songs are pretty awesome. So let's get this review. Get up and get your grandma out of here. Pick up, old Jim is working hard this year. And baby, do the things she says to do. If you're feeling good, baby, if you're feeling nice, you know your man is working hard. He's worth a deuce.
Start the call and I try to make the midnight show. Everybody's gonna move their feet.
Get down.
Everybody's gonna leave their seat.
We'll be right back.
The re-recorded versions of these songs that the current lineup has done, they're pretty cool. They don't replace the original versions, they just give you a new way to listen to them. I'm not a fan of all of the ones that they've done. I'm a fan of most of them, except for one, Forever. I was never a fan of that song to begin with, but the rest of them, they redid them pretty well. The inside of the album is pretty cool. You got a live 35 picture of the disc is pretty cool. There's another version of this album out there where you get a CD and a DVD. I'm not sure what the DVD has, but that'd be pretty cool. Okay, so that was Best Kissology. I'm a little small best stuff thing to talk about. Really don't talk about best stuff as much on this review series, but let's move on to the main thing, Sonic Boom. Now, Sonic Boom, I was hearing about Sonic Boom coming out for a while now, and when I first heard about it, I was like, cool, Kiss is coming out with a new album, and I was really looking forward to getting this album. And I got this album on the day of release, and I went into Walmart and I walked out with this album, and I walked out with also Love Gun and Rock and Roll Over. And Sonic Boom, in my opinion, is an awesome Kiss album to come back with after, you know, Psycho Circus. And the cover is a really cool cover. Like, they've kind of redid the Rock and Roll Over cover, and in my opinion, I thought that was pretty cool. And the songs are pretty cool songs. Let's get this review started.
but your back won't slip. Such a pretty sight. You try to talk, but you just can't speak. For the taking, give me love till I'm shaking. Give me rules just for breaking. Because it's never enough, never enough, never enough. People waste
Some of my final thoughts on Sonic Boom. Like I said, this is a really cool album for them to come back with after Psycho Circus. And the songs are really cool also, so here are the songs. Modern Day Delilah. This is a really cool opener. I love this song, and I love the fact that they use it as the show opener during the 2010 tour. Next is Russian Roulette. This is another cool Gene song, and I really love this song. Next is Never Enough. Really love this song. And another cool song. Next is Yes I Know Nobody's Perfect. This is my favorite song off of the album. And I just love this song. Next we got Stand. Stand is okay. I mean, I'm not really that big into it, but it's listenable. Next we got Hot and Cold. This is a really cool song. They actually played the song live during their Kiss Cruise 7. And after it's cool to hear another song off its album being played live. Next we got All for the Glory. This is another cool song. I love the fact that Eric Singer got his own song to sing. But I love his voice. He's got a really cool voice. Next is Dangerous. This is an okay song. I like it. I'm an Animal. Really love this song. And I love the fact when they played this on the tour, the lights were changing colors to go along with the song. That was really cool. When Lightning Strikes. I like this song. I like the fact that both Tommy and Eric have their own songs to sing. I just wish that, they would have a chance to sing their songs live. I actually wished they would have sang When Lightning Strikes during the Sonic Boom tour, rather than just having Fair sing Shock. That would have been more cool. Next, we have Say Yeah. I like the song. It's a cool ending. But I know they're actually playing the hell out of the song a lot. I also wish they would just play something else from the current era, like a song from another. If not, play something else from Monster, play something else from this album. That'd be really cool. So yeah, Sonic Boom. I'll do final verdicts later. So let's move on to the next one, and that is Monster. Now, Monster kind of really snuck up on me. I really didn't know Kiss was making another album until it was kind of given to me as a birthday gift, and it was like, here it is. Like, cool, they came up with another album. And I listened to it, and it's a pretty good listen. So let's get this review started. We'll be right back.
You can't stop the roll of the thunder. Yeah. You wanna take a shot, so give me all you got. Can't break the spell that I'm under. No. And the battle never ends, and the soldiers never die, and you don't back.
I'm going back. fear that you wanna see. We're giving up eventually, yeah, yeah. So come on and open your eyes. Y'all ought to know this, Kiss Army.
On Monster. This is a really kick-ass album with some really kick-ass songs. So let's talk about the songs. Heller Hallelujah. My first exposure to this song was on the radio when I guess they were promoting the album. And let me tell you, when they did the tour with Motley Crue, they did a lot more songs promoting the album than they did actually doing it for the actual Monster tour, which is kind of a letdown. But Heller Hallelujah is a really awesome song, and it's a really cool opener. Next we got Wall of Sound, really fucking cool song. Love this song, and it's really cool to hear it live, and I actually wish they did it for the actual Monster tour, but no, they did it for the 2012 tour. Bummer. But still, this is a really cool song. Next we got Freak, love the song. And next we got Back to the Stone Age. Favorite song off the album. Love this song. So cool. Next we got Shout Mercy. At first I wasn't really into the song, but after listening to this album a few more times, the song has kind of grown on me. So Shout Mercy is a really cool song. Even though it's got the cheesy woo-hoos, it's still a pretty cool song. Next we got Long Way Down. I really like the song. They've tried to play the song live. The only tour they have it is the 2012 Buenos Aires show, and Paul really could not do it. Actually, neither Paul or Gene had it that day, which is kind of rare for Gene, but 2012, that was kind of like the beginning of the end for Paul. Next we got Eat Your Heart Out. I like the song. Kind of cool to hear that kind of acapella thing at the beginning. Then we get into the actual song. Pretty cool. Next we got The Devil Is Me. Really like this song. It's kind of like a demon track. So I really like the song. Next we got Out of This World. I kind of like the song. It's another cool Tommy song. I also like the fact that they actually let him play this one compared to not letting him sing When Lightning Strikes. That was pretty cool. And next we got All for Love of Rock and Roll. This was a song that they would actually let Eric Singer sing live. Not just for the Kiss cruise, but he did sing it during Buenos Aires 2012 show. That's pretty cool. I just wish they would have let him have that song throughout the whole tour, not just a one-off show. Next we got Take Me Down Below. Really like the song. It's got that AC/DC-like intro, kind of like a Dirty Deeds or TNT-like intro. But it's just a basic, more sex song. No surprise that Kiss would make a song like this. But it's cool to have like the Paul and Gene back and forth vocals. It's really a fun song to listen to. Next we got Last Chance. A nice song to close the album off with. But we got bonus tracks. The first bonus track is a live song of King of the Night's on World from a Rock the Nation tour. And I think the show was from Virginia Beach, where they took the song from. Because I think Virginia Beach is where they played King of the Night's on World. And I don't think they kind of messed with the track that much, comparing it to the original audio. Which is kind of cool that they took something from the Rock the Nation tour and put it in Monster. Well, this version, that is. And the last bonus track is Right Here Right Now, which is an iTunes exclusive. And that song is awesome. That was it for Monster. And the last thing we're going to be talking about is an EP between Kiss and a Japanese K-pop band. So let's get into that. Apparently in 2015, Kiss did a collaboration with a K-pop band called Clover Z, and they did a song called Samurai Son. The K-pop band did a version of that song, and Kiss did a version of it, and made an EP of it. And the K-pop band also covered a Kiss song, Rock and Roll All Night. And also, Kiss put Samurai Son on a single disc version of Kiss 40. I was going to review another best of. I was going to talk about it in the EP because I thought, you know, maybe there'd be more to talk about. And there was. So let's get this review started. Sure, here's my final thoughts on the EP of Kiss and Clover Z. There's two covers to that EP. There's one cover where the members of Kiss are in the sky and the K-pop band is looking up. And then there's another cover that's kind of golden, and Gene's got these really cool wings, and that's so fucking cool. I like that cover better than that other cover. So I went with that cover to make the sample with. So anyways, let's get on with the songs. We got, well, the folder kind of fucked it up, but I'll do the best I can. We got Rock and Roll All Night, which is the cover that the K-pop band did, and that cover is pretty cool. They actually added some Kiss riffs, although Love Gun was one of them. And so yeah, that's a pretty cool cover. And then we got a vocalist version of Rock and Roll All Night, which is, you know, whatever. It's just the instrumental version of Rock and Roll All Night by the K-pop band. Next we got Samurai Son. I used to not like this song, but as you know, as I got older and started listening to the song more, you know, the song grew on me, so I kind of like the song more. And again, we got an instrumental version of Samurai Son without Kiss singing. Then we got the K-pop's version of Samurai Son, and it's, you know, them singing in Japanese, and it's cool for what it is, and like, can't understand a word they're saying. And I think Kiss is doing the backup vocals for their version. Just like the K-pop band was doing backup vocals along with Kiss for Samurai Son. So I thought that was pretty cool. And yeah, the folder just kind of has the rest of the stuff. So anyways, that was everything with current Kiss in the studio. So now let's get on to final verdicts. Now, the Japanese best of Best Kissology, it doesn't have really much in the sense of new. Yeah, the current lineup is good according to the classic Kiss songs, but that's all it really has going for it. But at the end of the day, it's just the number best of. So it gets the best of verdict, which is 7 out of 10. And that's really all it gets. Now, Sonic Boom, this is a really cool album to come back with, and I would give it a 10 out of 10. Really like the songs, with the exception of one, which we stand, and I kind of like the songs, but yeah, 10 out of 10. Monster is another really cool album as a follow-up to Sonic Boom, and it would get another 10 out of 10. And got some cool songs, got some nice bonus tracks. So yeah, 10 out of 10. The Samurai Son EP, I think it's only worth hearing the K-pop's version of Samurai Son, Kiss's version, and the K-pop's version of Rock and Roll All Night. So after that, they just kind of repeat themselves with instrumental versions, and that's pretty much it. So I would give it a 6 out of 10, and that's not a bad verdict. It's got some good songs, only 3 songs worth listening to, but I'm not going to give it a full 10 out of 10 just for the fact that, you know, they repeat themselves with fucking instrumental tracks. But yeah, 6 out of 10. So that's my review of everything current Kiss we did in the studio. Hope you liked it. Next time we meet, we're going back to the tribute albums with a tribute album set, but I wanted to talk about for a while, and that's the KAOL albums. Later.